Yes, ma'am.
Could you go ahead and do 30 and 31 for me?
I could.
I would really appreciate it.
Oh, would I? You didn't say would I, you said could I.
Well, I would really appreciate it if you would.
All right, 30 says, favor is deceitful and beauty is vain, but a woman that feareth the Lord, she shall be praised. So most of the time, people are just trying to have favor with somebody. You know, they're trying to be in favor with people of stature and importance. And he says favor is deceitful, because you can have favor today and fall out of favor tomorrow. Favor is not a continual thing. Or you can have favor with a person and the person dies. And so that favor is gone. So favor can be. And beauty is vain. Beauty, I don't care how pretty you are. I don't care how pretty you are. You're going to grow old and darkness changing. Now you might be pretty among the old, but ain't nobody looking but the old. Oh, Lord, have mercy. See, when you're pretty among the young, everybody looking. But when you're pretty among the old, the young ain't stuck you. So beauty is vain. In other words, to run after favor, to run after beauty, you'll get nowhere. He says, but a woman that feareth the Lord shall be praised. A woman that reverence God. God will cause people to acknowledge you as somebody. And this is what he's saying. She's going to be. Now she's not seeking praise. She's just seeking the Lord. But the Lord says, I'm going to have them praise you. He causes them to be. Then he says in verse 31, give her of the fruit of her hands and let her own works praise her in the gates. So he's saying you just leave her alone and she will benefit from those things that she do, because she's doing things to help others. And so as a result, she's going to wind up being praised from other people. You know, mother so-and-so, oh, ain't nobody like her. She'll do so-and-so, 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 and so on and so forth. She bought my kids. We didn't have no clothes 1 year. And she took me to the store and bought everybody something that they needed. And said, man, ain't nobody like her.
That's why you say you don't have to be married. You don't have to be in the church for this to work. Because there's one that's
correct.
Like an open.
This will work. This will work. Just like in the natural, a woman and a man that's married. A submissive woman will keep that man, save the unsaved. That is the law of God. It's not relative to salvation. See, in salvation, she's ordered to be submissive. In the world, she's not ordered, but if she do it, it'll work the same. These are principles that just work because God put them in the place of the natural workings of man, and they just work. Having compassion for your fellow man, that works. That works, saved or unsaved. All right? All right.